Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver Hacking Series. In this series, I'm going to discuss the most famous cyber attack, phishing. I thought to do a video on phishing because rapidly the phishing attacks percentage is increasing. And it would be helpful to raise some awareness around it. The objective of this video is to give awareness and education purpose. All the scenarios show in the video are only for education purpose. Please find the timestamp. Without further delay, let's get into the video. What is phishing? Phishing is an example of social engineering in which a target or targets are contacted by email, phone, or text message to trick the people into falling for a scam. Typically, the intent is to get user to reveal the financial information, system credential, or any other sensitive data. Here is the scenario. Callie is running a YouTube channel successfully. Evil hacker is planning to hack her YouTube and disrupt the service and reputation. To do that, hacker need her Google account password. So once he got the password, he will be able to access the account and the hacker will stop the service or he will be delete the videos, whatever he wants to do it on. So how he is going to achieve this, he is going to use a phishing technique to steal her credential. It is a demo time. For this demonstration, I have already set a Kali Linux and Windows 10 machine. So I'm going to perform my attacks from the Kali. Before starting it, disclaimer, hacking without permission is illegal. This video is only for education and awareness purpose. I'm performing this demo in my lab environment. I'm not hacking any real-time things. Okay? And this scenario, I just created it for the education purpose. So let's open a terminal. So as a first step, we are going to download the famous phishing script Black Hive. Let's open a Firefox. Copy this one. Sudo git clone and paste it. So Kali comes with a git cloning. Enter and it will prompt for the password. So the cloning is started. Okay. So the file is, we have successfully cloned it. So let's go to the folder Black Hive. LS. So we are going to run this script. Before running the script, step number two, we are going to create a phishing link, which is can be able to access outside or in the internet. So to do that, we're going to use ngrok. ngrok is a service used to create a secure tunnel between the internet and internet network endpoints. You can access and share the locally hosted application or content or website on the internet. It is a free. All you need to do is sign up with a valid email address. After signing up, just go to setup and installation. Copy this completely. Go to the terminal. Sudo, because it is a script. So the typo, I got it. Sorry, my bad. So you have to use, it's a bash script. So that's why you have to put it. And now add this token to there. Okay. So you can see now the token is added successfully. So now let's go to the script and sudo black I and let's run the script. So now you can see that there are a lot of templates are available. You can play around. So like Instagram, Facebook, Snapshot. So a lot of options are there. So it's all templates are available. Even you can have a Wi-Fi, even you can create a customs. So there are plenty of options are you there. You can play around and comment below what is your favorite option after you're testing on it. Okay, so let's stick with the scenario. So in this scenario, I'm just going to steal the Kali's Google credential. So I'm selecting the Google template, which is 6. So it's downloading the ngrok. So I have already downloaded the ngrok. So, and it is starting the PHP server and it is starting the ngrok server. So the link should be, so script is actually generating, but I am unable to see the link. So what the alternative solution is, SE toolkit, which is comes again, which inbuilt tool comes with the Kali Linux. So what we will do is, so let me go back it, exit, and let me clear it. So let's sudo SE toolkit. This is a command. If you are using for the first time, it will ask you to agree or deny it. So you have to agree it. So I did it already. So once you are used inside this toolkit, we are going to, so these are the options will be available. So select the option 1, social engineering technique. And in this one, we are going to website attack vector. So press 2. And here we going to use a credential harvesting attack. So 3, okay. And so this template, I'm just going with you, even you can use a custom template. You can copy and you do it, or even you can, or you can clone the site. For example, if I have a Netflix or if I have any other site, you can clone it here. I'm just going with the template because in the template itself, Google will be available. So click website template plus 1, and I'm just going with the default option, and here I'm going to use a Google template, and it takes some time. And okay, so you can see that credential harvest is running on the port number 80, and the informations will be displayed when the things over there. Okay, so let me go here, type localhost. You can see this is a Google image. This is a Google credential pages coming over there. And you can see this, the request is going on. So now I need to convert this. For example, if I'm giving the IP address, it will not be available internet. So that's why the ngrok comes into place. So now what I need to go to do is I'm going to make this locally one available so that I can able to access in the internet. So to do that, ngrok HTTP. So it's using port number 80. So I'm just giving the same thing, 80, enter. So now you can see this, the conversion is started. So now I need to copy this URL, copy the selection. So let's go and see whether this is working on it. Paste, enter. Okay, so it's working on it. So you can see the requests are coming here, and even you can see this, it's happening over there. So now good to go with it. So now the link is ready. Now we have to send a phishing email to Kali, but it should be a promising and not suspicious. I got the email address of Kali. It is actually she given that address in the YouTube about page and her social media itself. So it's easy for me to got that one. So now what I'm going to use for sending the email, I'm going to use this tool. So to make it very simple, I just type composed already everything. So the name looks like YouTube and the email is comes like youtube@google.com. And this is her email address. And I put a subject like your streaming was interrupted due to copyright issues. So that is we need to put a promising, and it should not be a suspicious, so automatically in a copyright issues are, it's very important for the YouTubers. So immediately they will start and they look it on it. So I'm just putting on it. So again, the scenario is just a demonstration and awareness purpose. So please do not use this. And so what I'm giving is, for more information, please visit our website. So I'm just going to and click and paste this link. Okay, so I'm just clicking on it. Again, you can do a more, what you can do is you can make it as a very short URL so that people will not know what is ngrok or something else or something else. You can make other tools on it, but I'm not going to more about it. Okay, so let's go and send this one. So the email is sent. Okay, so the Cali received that email, and you can see that it comes from the Google YouTube @google.com because we spoofed the domain. And so what is she's like, okay, and she's clicking the link in the agency, and it will take us to the login page. So since it is a Google, YouTube is there. So what she will think is, okay, it's a legitimate kind of thing, but she will not notice these things. As I said earlier, you can use the shorten the URL, or even you can use a lot of techniques. So now what I'm just doing is, I'm just going to use a cali.do@gmail.com, and password is, I'm just going to give a password, okay, and signing, I'm just giving on it. But let's go to the attacker machine and see what it got. So here you can see, this is her email address and this is the password. So now the attacker got the credential of Cali. The hacker can use these credentials and log into the Gmail as legitimate one, hack the YouTube or delete the videos, whatever it is present over there, and you can do it on it. So this is how the attackers are gaining the credentials using the phishing. So for this demonstration, you are just seeing the URLs and other factors that are there, but in the real time, they can tune it properly so that you will not feel suspicious on what you are doing it. So they will shorten the URL, or they will use lot of techniques are there. So for example, this is actually a new technique, a new browser in the browser, which is phishing, which is actually this year they have it added. So what here is this? So usually when you are visiting some page, you will have an option like continue with Apple or login with the Google or continue with the Facebooks or something else, right? So even they are the technique, new technique called browser in the browser technique. So what it will do is, so when you click that, you feel like you are opening the new sign in, like a sign in with the Microsoft. You see the URLs also look like legitimate, but they have hide it. But this is completely phishing one. So once you type this one, the username passwords will be available for the stem, for the actors. So this is the browser in browser new technique, which is reported on March 21st and 2021. So which is published in the Hacker News. I'll be giving the link in the description. And today they are went to the next level. So today they have booted in a Chromium browser in a shell phishing attacks. So for example, what they will do is, for this things, attacker need first of all, he need to gain access to the machine. So then he or attacker can run an application. So this is a cross, this one, this technique, it will be working on cross platforms. Even you can execute this code. So basically this is a something code. So you can see this is a phishing. This is a original one. So what you think is, this is a what you will be giving the credentials, and you will be giving on it. And once you give in, it will be available. You think your credentials will be available on it. So this is actually reported, has been identified today. So it's also available in the Hacker News. So I'll be giving the link in the description. So you can maybe look around it. So there are, this phishing techniques are improving it, and the, as I said in the beginning, so the percentage of the rate was higher. Even social engineering's, even Ubers are getting into it, and a lot of peoples are getting into phishings and losing the credentials. And so your credit card, sometimes in this one, instead of credentials, they will give you up asking for a credentials, fill this forms, details, credential details, bank details, confidential files. They will use this phishing can be used on many ways. The highlight is even using this phishing, they can download malware on your laptops. They can encrypt. It can be anything. It can be a keylogger. It can be a malicious programs to spy on you, or it might be a ransomware. So even using this phishing technique, even they can make you to download the softwares as well. So now what we will see is we will see the how to protect from the phishing. So please enable the spam filter. If you are an individual, like if you are using a Gmail, Hotmail, or those things, please use a spam filter. If you are enterprise, please tune your SPF records so that you can avoid this kind of such of domain spoofings, and those things and all will be blocked in the email gate certificate securities as well. Think twice before clicking the link. Just see whether what link it is. What is that thing? So please check the link before it, or before clicking it, just go through twice time, read the email, those things and all that. Verify the sender and sender email address. Cross-verify it. Sender and sender email address. Okay. And use a cloud-based sandbox. There are plenty of sandbox available in the market, in the web also. Even I have made a video how to analyze the URL without opening the in your computer. I'll be giving the link in this description as well. So there are a lot of sandboxes available. Please do it. And also use anti-malware program. If, as I said, right, if something is, for example, when you click some malicious URL, automatically your website says you are going to visiting a malicious website or something else. Or if anything gets downloaded, it will be deleted. So you will be protected on it. Last and finally, use multi-factor authentication. Even though hacker got your credential, still multi-factor authentications will prevent you to getting into your systems to be hacked. Please use multi-factor authentication. It can be a multi-authentication app, which is available in a phone, or you can use your text messages, OTP codes as well, or you can use a YubiKeys. There are a lot of options out there. So look around the multi-factor authentications to protect your credentials and your infrastructures. I hope the video is useful. Please share this awareness video with your colleague, friends and family, especially your grandparents and old people, because they are very easy targets. Phishing attack can be used to steal financial record, identify theft, confidential documents, etc. Please try to give like, comment and share the video for spreading the awareness so that this video will reach out to everyone. If you think the video was helpful, please consider subscribing to the channel and share your feedback and comment below the video. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please reach out to me via Discord and Telegram. Links are in the description. Please follow me on the LinkedIn and Twitter for channel updates. I'm running a survey, please OTO feedback so that I can understand your area of interest and requirement. It will also help me in creating a video for you guys and channel growth as well. Thank you to all who all have already voted and looking forward to hear from all of them. Bye, take care, see you soon with another interesting video.